Tasmania is a country of freaks. And I mean that in the nicest possible way, because I love freaks. Woo!
Australia has been a refuge for odd animals for millions of years. I want to figure out how far back in time this weirdness goes and see how strange it gets.
Lucy Cooke is on the Australian island of Tasmania, seeking out some of Earth's most peculiar animals. She wants to know why these critters evolved the way they did. For her, the odder the creature, the better.
Millions of years ago, evolution threw a curveball at this place, and the oddities on this isolated island never looked back.
Tasmania and Australia were once part of a supercontinent called Gondwanaland. When it broke apart, plants and animals hitched a ride and spent millions of years evolving in isolation. Like its marsupials, a group of mammals that raise their babies inside a pouch on their bellies. Most people associate kangaroos with the land down under, but did you know that there are more than 140 other marsupial species roaming these parts? And after around 40 million years of evolving in isolation, they've developed some distinct features.
So this is really interesting for me because I have never seen a marsupial's pouch before. This is where it gives birth to a tiny, weeny little jelly bean of a baby that then crawls up into the pouch and then grows up inside the pouch.
Or consider the wombat. Over the course of millions of years, this marsupial has developed protection in a rather cheeky place.
The thing that I really love about wombats is that they've got a reinforced bottom.
Do you want to feel a wombat's bum?
I'd love to feel a wombat's bum. That is extraordinary, isn't it? It's just totally, if you could feel this, it's completely reinforced. It's like it's made of bone.
Good weapon as well when he needs it to be, absolutely.
What kind of a weapon?
It's a bashing weapon. He likes to hand out a bum bashing if required, this boy. So if something's being really persistent, dog or a dingo squeezes between him and the top of the burrow and he'll start slamming with full force and actually can crush the skull of a dog or a dingo and kill it with a single hit.
That's amazing.
Yet the animal that most interests Lucy is even older, stranger, and more elusive than marsupials.
I've managed to blag my way onto a sort of expedition to look for what is probably Tasmania, if not the planet's, most peculiar animal. It's got the bill of a duck, the body of a beaver, and it also lays eggs.
The platypus, a creature with possibly the most mishmashed combination of features in the animal kingdom. And Lucy's joined a team of scientists to study one in the field.
This is the oldest mammal in all of Australia. Before marsupials, this animal was swimming the rivers of Tasmania with its amazing duck bill.
Fossils of platypus have been found that are like 110 million years old. This animal, or a version of this animal, walked the earth when the dinosaurs walked the earth.
In comparison, some of the earliest known human ancestors are only about 6 million years old. Retaining some reptilian-like traits, egg-laying mammals, known as monotremes, split off from the mammalian lineage before the evolution of the placenta, the protective structure that encases the fetus in most mammals.
The monotremes, the egg-laying mammals, are long thought of as being more primitive than our more sophisticated placental mammals.
Yet some of their abilities may not seem so ancient. Platypuses close their eyes, ears, and noses underwater and find prey by sensing electric currents with their duck-like bills.
That bill is more sophisticated, arguably, than anything that I've got. I can't detect dinner using electrical sensitivity. It makes you goose pimply to think about how that evolved. It's incredible.
The platypus has remained relatively unchanged for over 100 million years. Which makes one wonder, if the platypus has lived on Earth unchanged so much longer than humans, who's really the most adaptable?